Hi, I'm Wayne Godshall. I've been building live steam locomotives now for 31 years. We're here at the Mill Creek Central Railroad for the Buckeye Limited Convention. And I'm going to just tell my story here, how I got started at it and where I'm going with it. It started back in 1974. My dad and I were invited to a outdoor O-scale railroad in Elmira, New York, that was owned by Charlie Farmer. And we went up there, we had a good time, so we were invited back the next spring. And believe it or not, we got there, there was 1-inch scale live steam running around his property downtown. And he ran a 484 on charcoal because the neighbors didn't like the way that the coal soot was getting on their clothes, hanging on their line. So that was my first turn on the live steam. After that, we acquired a friend's father's 1-inch scale 040 chassis and a box of copper and some plans and 500 feet of rail. And my dad and I started in the live steam hobby. When we got done with our 1-inch scale railroad, we had over a mile of track down, and you can go back in some live steam magazines and see some of the meets we had and what it looked like. But I got into building the trains as a hobby, and I've kind of like turned it into a business. When I first started, I was working out of my basement, doing it 100% by myself and building engines from the ground up. I had a real good mentor in Joe Mastrocco, who believed in me as a machinist and that I could do it. And I flat out told him when I met him, I said, yes, I feel I can do it, but I don't know the names of the different parts of the valve gear and things to the locomotive. He says, I'll teach you. And over a 2-year period, he built an 1.5-inch scale Pennsylvania G5, and I built a 1-inch scale Pennsylvania G5. I still have that engine. It'll never go anywhere. We lost Joe almost 2 years ago at 95 years old. He was like a dad to me, and I really enjoyed talking with him. My phone call once or twice a week to him. So jump through time. I have probably 450 engines under my belt of rebuilds, boilers, valve gear, tires, whatever it needs done, we do. I have my son-in-law working for me, and I have 4 other guys in the shop. So we also have a job shop, and the trains have always been on the back burner. So with that being said, it's Godshall's Custom Machining, but it's not me anymore. It's just I've kind of like passed the torch on to my employees and my son-in-law. My grandson, pretty sure he's going to be taken over when I step away from it. I'm not done yet. I'm still got a lot to go. We had a close call last year, but I'm back at it feeling real good, and we are getting a lot of stuff accomplished. Sitting beside me here is the 19th consolidation that has come out of the shop, and this one's a little bit different. It's a CNO model and with a radial stay boiler rather than a bell pair boiler. And this one's actually going home to Georgia and on the 12th of August. So it's been a real good thing. But we have the job shop that keeps the money coming in, and the train side is keeps the hobby going. And I've been since 1977, since I graduated, I've been really pushing the live steam hobby and getting more and more people involved and liking what I do and believing in me to let me work on their steam locomotives and keep them going. The H10 beside me here is a 1.6 scale. I had started doing that because Joe told me if I was looking for a good engine to build in 1.6 scale that would sell, would be the H10 would be the way to go. And how it got started was he actually gave me the pencil drawing he did on a drafting table of the valve gear. So I took it and blew it up to 1.6 scale, had a pattern made for the casting, for the cylinder casting, and for the drivers, the stack, and the smoke box front. And everything else is pretty much fabricated on this one. The domes on the H10, the Pensy style, I get the steam dome and the sand dome cast. But and I buy the bells from Jim Edwards out on the West Coast. But since I got into building these about 6 years ago, I bought a business out of the Panhandle of Florida called American Model Engineering Supply that we actually fabricate the lubricators, ball valves, check valves, unions, all kinds of parts and pieces. So part of the job shop side is still manufacturing stuff for the hobby industry. And that's going real good. As a machinist and a manufacturer of these models, I see the hobby in the next decade, I should say. I see more of the steam locomotives being switched over to propane, because coal's going to get harder to come by. But I think as long as we keep it, we can keep it going, the younger generation will get the smell of the smoke and the feel of the heat and say, I want that steam engine. Because as a kid growing up, when I saw a steam engine, I was fascinated with it. And it's just really neat to be able to sit here and say, I know all the names of the parts of the locomotive and I've built them all. So it's really rewarding to know that I know this and I can pass the torch on, hopefully to my grandson. The one thing that I like doing is talking with young people and getting them involved in the live steam. I've been known to take engines that are hot and put younger people on them and teach them how to fire and run and try to, like Joe used to say, just put the hook out there. If you dangle it long enough, you're going to catch something. This hobby needs the younger people to come in because we're all getting older and we've lost a couple good builders here lately. And without the builders and the knowledge to do these locomotives, it can stop. I've always said live steam is the name of our hobby. It's not live diesel and it's not live electric. If someone didn't know about the hobby, I definitely want to teach them about the hobby. I have had 5 to 9 people already come into my shop, see what we're building, and have had Lionel layouts, HO layouts, N-gauge layouts, turn around, sell it all, and get into the hobby. There is nothing any more satisfying than to have the smell of steam oil burning, coal in your face, smoke, and it's very relaxing. It takes model railroading to the next level. And it's really kind of enjoying to sit back and talk trains, parts, machining, how you did this, how they did that. And what always gets me is you can have 5 different people doing the same thing. 5 different people have different ways to get to the same finished product. That's pretty cool because everybody has their own ideas. Over the years, some of my favorite equipment was of course, my Pennsylvania 10-wheeler, the G5, the 1-inch scale engine. But I also built, from the ground up, Pennsy Mountain, an M1A and an M1B with long haul tenders. I built a N2SA that's here at the track that was kind of a neat build to do. And we got a lot of, I'm finishing up a daylight right now, which is pretty cool. And some of my bigger engines that I've done over the past years have been a big boy, an inch and a half scale, a Challenger, an inch and a half scale, and an FEF3, an inch and a half scale. So, and I redid a Berkshire, I redid three Berkshires over the past 10 years. So, a lot of engines been through the shop, a lot of, it's pretty neat when somebody brings something in, find a problem, fix it, put it out. If we need to do a boiler rebuild, we'll tear the engine down, do a new boiler or rebuild a boiler, put it back together and get it back out the door. So we have them come in from all over the country. And even with the American Model Engineering Supply, we are selling all over the world. So it's kind of neat living in a small town of Shermansdale, Pennsylvania, to be able to send stuff all over the world is pretty cool. So I just wanted to thank everyone that's been behind me for the years. My wife and my son-in-law, Brad, who's running the shop now. And the guys working for me, Winston, Carl, Drew, Mike, they're all there helping. And if it wasn't for all you guys, I couldn't keep it going like it is. I appreciate it.
Thanks for tuning in for this video here on the Steam Channel. We hope you enjoyed it. Why not climb aboard for another high-quality Steam video in beautiful Ultra HD by clicking on one of the previews to your right?